Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. So today we're gonna be installing this soffit outlet right here for my Christmas lights and anything else I wanna hang out here. What I got is a weatherproof enclosure and we're gonna be installing it above the soffit. I'm also gonna be installing one of these out in the back by my pool pump where I need an outlet, so stay tuned. So we're gonna use this kit that I bought at Lowe's. This thing is only like $16. It comes with a water resistance outlet and everything you need to mount this thing outside. And it's a great value. If you need a GFI version, it's only like $5 more at $21, which is a good deal compared to the actual cost of just a GFI alone. So we're gonna install this today using a GFI that's already inside the garage. This thing comes with everything, all the hardware, all the plugs you need. If you actually have to install it onto the wall with some wings, this thing comes right here with two of these wings. You just install them into the prefab holes right here and then you bolt it surface mount to the wall. That way you don't have to drill into this box and penetrate it and lose its water tightness. So right now I'm installing an outlet right here on my CMU wall off of my sub panel that I installed recently. If you haven't checked out that video, go ahead and check out that video. I'm gonna put the GFI right here. I'm gonna put a secondary outlet right here. So I have four outlets on this wall. And I've already ran the wire up into the soffit and we're gonna tap that soffit coming off of this wire right here, which is gonna be the load wire. So this one GFI is gonna control everything down the line. In order to get into this soffit, what we need to do is start from the edge here. We gotta bend the edges back, take the nails out. There's periodic nails along this rail. Under this right here, there's actually more nails on each piece of the soffit. So you gotta pull those nails out. Usually they only use one. To do that, you can slide that whole panel out from the end. And that's the only way you can really take these things out without damaging anything. You could pull that nail and maybe bend it out and then drop it down. There's a nail right into the wood here and then it just sits on a rail on the inside. So we'll go ahead and do that now on a time lapse. All right, so we're in here. That came off pretty easily. I was able to take that lip off the edge here. I was able to pry that off. The end plate here wasn't bolted in with any screws, so that came off easily. And there was only one staple that ripped through right here because this thing actually was installed the other direction going this way, which is gonna make it harder to kind of put back together, but I'll manage with the new nail into there. I'm gonna go ahead and just mount the box to this rail right here, cut a hole for it, and then get it back up in there and sealed up with my wire drop that I've already left here. To seal it up, I actually just put this half inch nipple into here. And I'm just gonna fill it with some expanding foam. Hopefully that's good enough to seal this box up there. You could run some liquid tight, but you eventually have to seal it with some silicone or some expanding foam anyway, so it's the same as doing it right here. To mount this up to the 2x4s, I just found these two little truss L brackets I had laying around. And one of them I had to drill an extra hole to match it up. What I'm gonna do is just drill these right into the 2x4s. And that way I have a little bit of adjustment for height. And this is perfect because it kind of centers it right in the middle of the soffit. I forgot to put this gasket on first. So you have to put this gasket and then you gotta screw the outlet in with the gasket on. Actually, you have to screw it in with a cover on. So yeah, it's a kind of a stupid way to do it because especially in this position where we don't have an angle and we can't hold it up. So there we have it right there. I did kind of cut it a little bit too wide on the ends, but It's okay, it's an open soffit anyways, it just kind of hangs right there a little bit. Other than that, we got all the little edges bent back as good as we could. It still looks like bacon right now. So as I mentioned earlier, we're gonna be installing another box back here, but it's gonna be a surface mount one, and I'm gonna install it right here with the GFI coming off of this panel right here. So this is my pool pump panel right over here, which controls all my pool stuff and my controls for the pool. So they've made the circuits for that. So they've got the pool pump circuit, they've got the ozone bubble machine right there, and then the lights and controls, which is this. I'm gonna add another breaker right here, a 20 amp breaker, to feed this GFI down here so it can have some power outlets on this side of the house. So I'm gonna be mounting this right here. I ended up putting the ears right here on this box already so I don't have to penetrate any holes in this box. We'll just go ahead and mount it right about here and then run a piece of liquid tight conduit with the connectors on both sides between here and there, and we should be good with the outlet right there. All right, so we're inside the panel and we should be able to just put this 20 amp breaker right here, run the feed down to this knockout that's got a cap on it right now, and we should be good. So I'm gonna go ahead and put that through and get the liquid tight in and start fishing some wire in. All right, so I got everything hooked up with a liquid tight. I ran my 12 gauge wire through. I terminated it on the grounding block and the neutral block. Then I attached it to my new 20 amp breaker. So right now, I'm gonna go ahead and just wire up the GFI down here before I stick the breaker in and turn it on. All right, there we have it, guys. Got this baby connected up. Looks like the watertight GFI works. We hit the test button, clicks, push the reset. The light comes back on. We have a nice watertight outlet right here by the pool pump. I'll break that last knockout right there and put this thing back on here and we should be good. Hey guys, thanks for joining me all the way to the end of this electrical installation video. As you can see, adding these outlets was a pretty simple process if you're comfortable with wiring stuff up and messing with electricity around the house. Remember guys, on all these different home improvement projects or car projects or whatever I do, if I can do it, you guys can do it too. That's why I make these videos, to give you guys some confidence and show you guys a little bit of how easy it is to do these projects. If you found this video useful, give it a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed to your channel, go ahead and subscribe to your channel to stay on top of all my different DIY projects around the house. And I'll talk to you guys next time.